A very pleasant day to all. I am Dr. Manjula Devi, head of the Department of Chemistry from SNS College of Technology. Today we shall have a brief discussion on the case study of Delhi air pollution based on design thinking concept. According to WHO, the air pollution was estimated to cause nearly 4.2 million premature deaths worldwide in 2016. In India, 6 lakh deaths are annually attributed to air pollution. So the air pollution is especially higher in New Delhi. The results shows clearly the higher level of air pollution occurs only in winter season. So we shall have a look on this particular issue by getting a people's opinion on their sufferings and the issue's severity and the steps taken by the government is elaborately discussed in this case study. The air pollution in Delhi has created huge impact on the people who resides there. Some people said they are getting suffocated due to difficulty in breathing, and they are suffering from the skin diseases due to this pollution. It also lessens to stamina, it makes us feel uneasy, and many old age people resulting with asthma and suffering a lot. Some feel their lungs are aching badly, not able to sleep at night, smell so horrible, feel the burning sensation, etc. So November 8, 2016 morning 9 AM in Delhi, inside the train the air quality standard was 352. So the people are severely instructed to wear gas mask, and also outside the street and outside the street as well as in the roadside it was recorded as 405. And also morning in November 8, 2019 AM morning 6 o'clock, the inside the hotel the air quality standard was 405. So all the people are instructed to wear the mask while eating and drinking in restaurant. Expert says air pollution in Delhi would get worse in coming days. And also this is the highway in New Delhi, the smog, there was a smog. So actually the driver could not see where they are going. So about almost 24 vehicles got damaged as drivers kept crashing into the pileup. It nearly hits 30 million people. Scientists estimated that people spending a day outside is like smoking 50 cigarettes per day. So in the last 10 years, Delhi population has increased to 7 million. Today it is the largest second city in the world as well as most polluted city in the world. So, but this cloud of pollution is not completely from Delhi. Already I said it is coming out from Punjab and Haryana, known as India's breadbasket. So they are the key region for country agriculture. Farmers grow rice, they request more water, so they start to use more water, the groundwater goes on decreasing. To save water, Act was passed in 2009. It bans the rice planting before mid-June, so they can't plant rice until before the monsoon. So when the rain comes to replenish groundwater, that pushes rice harvesting later into the year. Farmers have less time to get their field ready for their next crop. To clear the field quickly, they start to burn. Every year there results to massive cloud of smoke, the two major reasons for them to attend New Delhi. First is geography. Himalayas mountain acts as a barrier and direct smoke towards the Delhi. And second is weather. In winter, cloud mountain air rushes down towards the Delhi from Himalayas. So these are the major reasons the air coming out from Haryana and Punjab to the New Delhi. So the warm air keeps the pollution trapped on the ground. When the fire smoke dries the New Delhi, then it is mixed with the urban pollutions like vehicle emission, forming a toxic smog. Smog was developed on the top of the cities. So we have the most hazardous air pollutions of almost every year. In November 2019, Supreme Court ruled that states of North had to stop the burning of crops, but it could not be stopped. So instead, when pollution spikes in October and November, city officials changes the things that they can control, but the crop burning was still happening. The spikes were back over the years. This pollution makes the life of many people at risk. Steps taken by authorities to tease out risk of air pollution level in Delhi. First thing is odd even policy on vehicles. As per the rule, morning 8 a.m. to evening 8 p.m., private non-commercial vehicles allowed out on the roads on alternative days. Odd days, if the vehicle's license plate ends in odd number, are allowed. Even days, if it ends in even numbers, are allowed. Metro announces more trips and public transport buses increases its number. So the Delhi Metro Corporation is running 3,317 train instead 3,131, an increase of 181 train trip to provide increased capacity to public in this weather. The Delhi Transport Corporation has been directed to have 400 buses on a short-term basis. Later 300 buses were procured, more to handle the rush and due to odd and even scheme. Ban on civil construction and strict compliance of graded responses action plan. The construction dust is also one of the major pollution, and hence Delhi government has imposed a ban on construction demolition activities. And according to the strict compliance of Great Response Action Plan, the effective enforcement of ban on diesel generator sets, stone crushers and brick kilns. The Graded Response Action Plan will be implemented by the Central Pollution Control Board to monitor air quality. Only the trucks carrying essential commodities are allowed into the cities. All the other heavy vehicles and trucks have been prohibited from entering the cities. Ban of firecrackers. Over 80% of the Delhi people abide the law of Supreme Court. They have stopped the burning of firecrackers on Diwali. And also the ban of Diwali does not ruin the festival of light. Expert says that it saves the people from hazardous chemicals like mercury, lead and aluminium. Has anything changed after everything banned? Yes, it has been changed a little. Comparatively, before and after banning, there is a little improvement. There is no drastic change, even the changes are fluctuating. Even though we did do many things to reduce or to control air pollution, but we could not made what we expected. But this pandemic helped to destroy this deadly killer, air pollution. This lockdown for pandemic outbreak, corona, helped the earth to heal from those air pollution, traffic congestion, noise pollution, clear sky, a load of birds tripping, banned humans, vehicles and machineries. Building in New Delhi after and before pandemic. The India Gate after and before pandemic. Lodhi Garden after and before pandemic. And the Yamuna River, after and before pandemic. At last, whatever may be the human error, the nature recovered itself. Let's continue at least this to save the nature. Thank you. Jai Hind.